does attracting a COO mean that you offer them next, that they're up next?
I don't think it's essential that you do that, again, because as I mentioned, many aren't really interested in that position next. I think what's critical is that there be clear communication, because the last thing you want to have happen is for the COO to become impatient. When that happens, they're either going to begin to become tempted to say and do things that might actually be undercutting the CEO a little bit. In fact, we've had COOs tell us that that's when they knew it was time to leave, when they got to the point where the CEO would make a decision and their first reaction was not, okay, how do I make this happen? Their first reaction instead was, that's not really what I would do. Once the COO starts thinking that way, that relationship needs to end. So essentially what happens is if you get the COO ready too soon, you're going to lose them. They're going to want to go someplace else. So it's essential that you be really fair and upfront with people around timing and expectations. So if you bring somebody in and they think it's 3 years and now you're in year five, that's not going to end well for everybody involved.